Here for the next session of the gravity dam. This when we were talking about the dams, in the classification of dam based on the hydraulic and structural action, we have seen the classification in three forms. One was the earthen dam, second is the gravity dam, and one was the arch dam. This is one of the types in which this dam, in which all the external forces, they are acting on that dam, they are resisted by means of its self-worn weight. The self-worn weight is the term which is known as the gravity forces. If you go by definition, what is gravity dam? The dam in which all the external forces are resisted by means of gravity dam is the dam in which all the external forces are resisted by means of its own weight. There are number of forces acting on the dam. The forces are due to water, they are due to self weight, they are due to seepage water, they are due to wind, they are due to earthquake. All these forces are required to be resisted by means of the weight of the dam. So it is not the reinforcement that is taking tension. It is not the concrete only that is taking compression. It is not both together taking bending. It's the own weight, the own weight of the dam which takes the external load. All external loads, they are acting at different point of location. Those different point of locations will cause different moments. Those moments along with the forces will be causing some anticlockwise moments, some anticlockwise moments, some rotations. All these forces and moments are required to be resisted by means of the own weight. Why we say this is a hydraulic structure? It is said the hydraulic structure because there is no reinforcement. Only self-weight is acting. So in return, to resist all those external forces, we need to have very huge mass, huge weight of the dam. That huge weight of the dam makes the gravity dam section very huge. And it is that huge section in the form of huge weight that resists all the external forces. So in the gravity dam, necessarily you need a very sound foundation to resist this weight of the dam. Otherwise, if you provide the gravity dam, if you construct the gravity dam on a soft foundation, whole of the dam will sink down, and this will be known as punching shear. The punching shear failure can be avoided by providing the sound foundation. The safety and stability of the gravity dam can be vouched by having the sound foundation. With this conceptual introduction, now we will see the different aspects of the gravity dam. In this chapter of the gravity dam, we are supposed to discuss the number of different forces acting on the dam, the number of different moments due to these different forces acting on the dam, then how their resultant is passing, and if the resultant is not passing through the center of gravity of the dam, and if it is making the eccentricity, then how that eccentricity is to be coped up with, and how the stability of the dam is defined, how it is maintained, how it is to be achieved against all the moments, all the forces. If this safety and stability aspects are not taken care of, in that case dam fails. So if at all dam has to fail, in which modes it will be failing? Whether it will be failing due to tension or due to compression or due to bending or due to overturning or due to sliding, all these are different modes of the failures which we are required to be discuss in this chapter. And at the end of this chapter, we will be also taking the glance at what are the safety design requirements, how to design the safe dam, safe gravity dam, what are the different methods to design the safe gravity dam, and we will be also touching some discussions on the aspects of at actual construction of the dam. So in general, in this chapter we are going to design the dam, we are going to discuss the design aspects of the dam, we are going to discuss analysis aspects of the dam, and we are also going to discuss the construction aspect of the dam. All these three aspects will give you the overall idea about the gravity dam. The dam one which you are seeing here is the Sardar Sarovar project, very prestigious project of the country. This is the portion which you are seeing, is the dam portion, main dam body. Of course it is part of the portion is shown here, and this portion which you are seeing is the spillway portion. The spillway also, you will see again two types of the spillways are provided. In this portion the spillway is different, and in this last portion, end portion, the spillway is different. That is a different topic of discussion. I will not touch to that. Right now we can proceed to the thing. That this is the overall section of the gravity dam. In this section, this is the upstream face, this is the downstream face, and upstream face will be retaining the water. This whole of the upstream face will be subjected to water, hydrostatic pressure. The pressure, water will be exerting a pressure on this. There are two possibilities of providing the upstream face. In first case, it may be only vertical face throughout from top to bottom. Generally it is designed like that only. And then that section which is adopted with the vertical upstream face, that is analyzed. If after analysis that section fails, what it indicates? That the weight of the dam is less to resist all the external forces. When the weight of the dam is less, it cannot resist all the forces. In that case, it is required to be increased. That weight is increased by providing the slant on the upstream side, as you are seeing. So the vertical surface, vertical face of the upstream, in some of such cases made slanted for certain height, which will be ultimately resulting in such increased weight of the dam, which gives the safe conditions for the safety and stability of the dam.